The 28 days of the female reproductive cycle can be divided into four phases. Days 1 through 5 of the monthly cycle are the menstrual phase. Low levels of progesterone and estrogen allow for the shedding of the stratum functionalis of the endometrium. These low levels allow the hypothalamus to release gonadotropin-releasing hormone, which in turn stimulates the release of follicle-stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone from the anterior pituitary. Increasing levels of follicle-stimulating hormone stimulate follicular development. Days 5 through 13 of the cycle consist of the preovulatory ovarian and proliferative uterine phases. The presence of follicle-stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone stimulates the development of ovarian follicles, which then increase their production of estrogen. The increased levels of estrogen stimulate the stratum basalis of the uterine endometrium to proliferate and thicken. As the ovarian follicles mature and make more estrogen, the high levels of estrogen create a positive feedback loop to the hypothalamus and anterior pituitary. This stimulates secretion of gonadotropin-releasing hormone, follicle-stimulating hormone, and luteinizing hormone, and further maturation of the follicles. On day 14, ovulation occurs as a result of a surge of luteinizing hormone, signaling the mature ovarian follicle to rupture and release a secondary oocyte. During days 15 through 28, the post-ovulatory and secretory phases of the ovarian and uterine cycles, the ruptured follicle collapses and reforms to become the corpus luteum. The corpus luteum secretes estrogen and larger amounts of progesterone, causing the endometrium of the uterus to further thicken. Glycogen is secreted from the endometrial glands to prepare for a possible embryo. Increased secretion of inhibin hormone signals the anterior pituitary to decrease secretion of FSH and LH. If the secondary oocyte is not fertilized, the corpus luteum disintegrates, and the cycle begins again.